Hi, this is Kayla from CreativeMinds. In this video, we're going to look at how to install and configure the CreativeMinds Tooltips Glossary plugin that you can download from WordPress.org. So once you install and activate the plugin, it will take you to the settings page. But we're going to start by adding a few glossary items to see how the plugin works. So in the left-hand menu, click on Glossary. And let's add a couple items. So I've got one in there now, WordPress, and I'll add in some content for the definition for this item. And publish. And now let's create a new item for CMS, Content Management System. Let's add in the definition for that as well. And you can make these as long as you like, and you can also add in media, images, or video. So now we have the two terms defined in the glossary. Let's see how the glossary is going to work on the site. So we're going to go to Pages and add a new page. We'll just add in a testing title, and we're going to write a sentence which includes both of the words in our glossary. And now let's publish the page and view the page. Now you can see that the words are highlighted, and if you hover over the words, it will give you the glossary definition that we inputted. And if you click on one of the terms, it will take you to the glossary term page. So let's now return to the settings page, so we can see how the glossary index page works. So the plugin will create an index page for all of the items in the glossary. And if you click on that page, you'll see it will take you to the index page, which has all of the terms defined. So there are many more features and customizations you can look at in the free version of the plugin, but we're not going to go over those in this video today. Instead, we're going to look at some of the common troubleshooting problems or errors that can come up. So the first error is that you might get a 404 error when viewing the term page. So if that happens, go to your WordPress settings and open up permalinks, and you need to make sure that your permalinks are set. So if it's blank, it's not set. And then after you set it, save it. And if they're already set and you're still having this problem, try saving it again and refreshing it in your WordPress installation. So if you add a new plugin, this sometimes needs to be reset. Another issue that can come up is that the tooltip doesn't appear on the page. So to troubleshoot this, you need to right-click on the page and click on Inspect, which will open the browser control dashboard, which can help you monitor problems. So this is usually going to be a JavaScript problem, so you need to look for JavaScript errors. So let's just install something with a JavaScript error so you can see. So usually if there's a JavaScript error, it means the tooltip will not show up. So those are the basic features of the plugin, and there's many more features you can use in both the free and in the pro version. Thank you for watching!